Hi guys, today we're gonna learn how to crochet these slippers.
We will be using Red Heart with Love yarn, and we will be using a size 4mm crochet hook. The first thing we're gonna do is make a loop stitch, chain 25, and then we will single crochet in every loop. When we get here, we will single crochet two more into the same stitch. Then we will continue to single crochet in every loop on the other side of the chain. Okay, so when we get to this point, we will single crochet two. Then we'll go in here and we'll slip stitch. Chain three. And then we will double crochet in every stitch for the entire row. When we get to the three stitches that were single crocheted into the same stitch, we will double crochet by two in every stitch. Okay. So in all four stitches, we will double crochet by two, and then we will continue to single crochet, and I'll check back with you later. And now we need to double crochet by two in every stitch, like we did on the other side. And then we will slip stitch in here. On the next row, we will chain one. And we will single crochet by one When we get to the point where we double crochet by two into the same stitch, we will single crochet by two in each of those stitches. And then we'll continue to single crochet. And I'll check back with you later. When we get to the point where we double crochet by two in every stitch, we will single crochet by two in each of those stitches, just like we did on the other side. Slip stitch. On the next row, we'll chain three and we will double crochet by one. After you finish double crocheting by one in every stitch, and slip stitch. Then chain one and then single crochet by one into the back loop of the chain on the top here. Okay, so not like this, but like this. And we will do that for this row only. After you finish this row, I will show you what to do next. To finish the row, slip stitch in here. Chain one and continue to single crochet for four more rows. After you finish the four rows, I will show you what to do next. Okay guys, so after we finish four more rows of single crochet, we'll chain one, we'll continue to single crochet, We'll start from the middle and then we will count 12 on one side and 12 on the other, and then we will mark those stitches. You can use yarn or safety pin or whatever you want, or you can just use a needle like I did now. Alright, so continue to single crochet until you get to the marked stitch. And now we'll start to decrease since we arrived at the marked stitch. So yarn over, put our hook through the marked stitch, yarn over, pull it through, put our hook through the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through, yarn over, pull it through all five stitches. Okay, so yarn over, put it through the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through, yarn over, put it through the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through, yarn over, pull it through. And we will do that until we get to this stitch. When we get to this point, we'll remove our marker and then we will continue to single crochet. Slip stitch, chain one, single crochet, until we arrive at the decreasing stitches. Okay guys, and now we will do the same thing we did on the previous row. So yarn over, put our hook through the stitch, yarn over, pull it through, yarn over, put our hook through the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through, yarn over, pull it through our five stitches. And we'll keep repeating that until we pass the decreasing stitches. continue to single crochet for the rest of the row. Slip stitch. Chain one and single crochet all the stitches for the entire row. Keep doing that and then I will show you what to do next. Slip stitch, expand your last stitch, and put your work through it. Pull the yarn, cut it, and loose the ends. So we will make a magic ring. Just wrap it once around your finger. Put your hook through the circle. And chain four. Single crochet. Chain three. Single crochet. Chain three. Single crochet. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One more. 2, 3. Single crochet. One, two, three. And we will put this one in the second chain. Okay, then we'll pull the yarn. The next thing we're going to do is we will do a single crochet within this chain here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, triple crochet. Chain one, triple crochet, and we'll go in the next chain here. Chain three, chain one, triple crochet. Chain three, chain one. We'll keep doing the same thing all around. we'll go in the fourth stitch of the chain, single crochet. That's how it looks so far. Now we will switch to another color. You don't have to do this. This is only if you want to. You can continue with the same color as well. Okay, so now that we switched yarns, we will chain one and we will single crochet six in the chain. So one, two, three, four, five, six, and then we will go to the column here and we will single crochet eight. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Again, in the column, single crochet eight in the next one. Single crochet six in the chain. Single crochet eight in the column. And we will keep doing that until we finish the entire row, and then I will show you what to do next. Okay guys, so after we finish the row, we will single crochet in the first one where we chained one in the beginning of the row, and that will be it. So the next step is to switch the yarn again. So chain with a teal color. All right. All right, so single crochet all around with a teal color. Okay, so keep single crocheting by one in every stitch, and I will check back with you later. Okay, you guys, so when you get to the last one, single crochet, pull this stitch, go in the back of the flower, put your hook through the single crochet, and then pull the stitch. And then cut the yarn here. Okay, you guys, so we cut this, pull this one, we cut the white yarn as well. Not too close, okay? Then we take a needle and we put the needle through the single crochets. Not through each one, but you skip by one. All right, that should be enough to hide this piece. And then we put the yarn through it. We pull it. And it's gone. Alright. So the next step is to do the same with the white yarn. So you go in the white single crochets. Let me do one more just in case, because this one seems a little longer. Alright, now we put this through the needle. Okay guys, and now we will attach this flower to the slipper. We'll use a tapestry needle. It doesn't matter the size. And we will use the denim color, or we can use white. So we will put the yarn through the tapestry needle. Cut it. We'll secure the end. We'll go from underneath. And we will sew each one of these in place. Put your needle through any of the stitches. Tie these two ends together. Twice. Take your scissors, cut the yarn. And this is how it will look like when it's finished. This is how the finished slipper looks like. I hope you guys like it. Thank you so much for watching. Please share and subscribe.